tea house since last year. It's a big old tea house all due time, and we do well, I can't deny. There's plenty of seats and plenty of fun, and lots of folk both old and young. Some folk eat and some sip tea. But if you're broke, well, watching's free. If you're a chess fan, come in and play for plate of meatballs. Losers pay. But listen, if you'd like to keep your pate, you'd better not discuss affairs of state. State affairs are a sorry mess. The Emperor's prestige is daily less, and our ministers, both military and civil, run when they see the foreign devil. Foreign goods fill the marketplace, and opium too, at a killing price. Poor peasant. They're the sorriest ones. They're forced to sell their daughters and sons. As the rich got richer and the poor got poorer, Tan Sitong rose up a martyr. And Liang Qichan, come your way. They believed reform could save the day. The Empress Dowager nearly burst. She raged, she ground her teeth and cursed. She screamed for blood, she screamed for heads. Reform's rebellion! So she said. So the less you say about reform, the longer you'll keep your head from harm. The tea is ready. So come on in to Yu Tai Tea House in Old Beijing.
Hey, Tang, take a walk somewhere else. Sit down! Look, if you don't stop smoking that damn opium, your luck is never going to change. See? I'm a better fortune teller than you.
Trouble again?
Okay.
Don't worry, it won't come to blows. If you're serious, they'd have gone out of the city long ago. Why come to a tea house?
Wait, what are you two talking about?
Me? Look, I've paid for my tea, but I have to answer to you as well.
Excuse me, sir. You serve in the Imperial Wrestlers, don't you? Sit down.
Well, I serve, I'm none of your bloody business.
If you want to throw your weight around, why don't you throw it at the foreigners? That's off all right. You're on the public payroll, aren't you? I know you are. So where the hell were you in the British and French race for summer college?
Shut your mouth. Don't piss me off.
My friends in the house, let's leave off discussing affairs of state, shall we? Master Erdezi, why don't you take a seat in the inner courtyard now?
What the hell do you think you're doing?
Maybe I don't touch foreigners. Maybe I don't. But I will give one of my touches I will. You best watch your back.
Young Master Erdezi. You're quite an important person, aren't you?
Master Ma, pardon me. I didn't see you sitting there.
Settle your disputes in a reasonable way. Must you always resort to aggression?
Yes, sir. I'll go straight to the inner courtyard. Oi, Lisa, I'm paying for this table.
Sir, you seem like a sensible man.
I have other matters to attend to. Bye.
No wonder he snubbed you. You offended him.
Offended him? This is my lucky day.
Look, Chang, he's saying something or other about foreigners now. Mm-hmm. Well, he lives off the foreigners, speaks their language, follows their religion. If he wanted to, he could go straight to the mayor of Beijing on official business.
No time for those who serve foreign muscles.
Watch what you say, Lisa, a fresh pot of tea here, please.
How much for that tea cup? I'll pay for it.
Don't worry, we'll settle it later.
Hey, my friend! You're early today! You must try this! Oh, I've just got it! All the way from England! So fine and pure! It's the real deal!
Even our snuff must come from abroad! How much silver must flow out of our country every year?
Our great Qing Empire has plenty of silver and gold. We will never run out of it. Sit back. I have some business to attend to.
Come on in.
Well, let's talk it over. Well, 10 taels of silver do.
Master Liu, is the 15 year old girl only worth 10 taels?
Well, if you sell her to a whorehouse, you may get a little bit more. But, oh my god, you are not willing to do that, are you?
My own flesh and blood, how could I?
She might be your flesh and blood, but you still cannot feed her.
Master Liu, you have to understand, I'm a very desperate man. No one cares for peasants anymore.
That's your problem. That's your problem, not mine. You ask me for help, and this is what I'm doing. I'm offering you the best. She will be well fed and well looked after. Look, I'm a pretty busy man. I have plenty of customers waiting in line for me. So much as to just look
at. I'm sorry, but who's being sold to?
This should please you. A palace official.
Well, palace official wants a peasant girl.
Exactly. Your daughter is a very lucky girl.
But who is he?
The Grand Eunuch Tang!
Well, you will have heard of him.
He is one of the great favorites of the Empress Dowager. You know what people say? They say even the vinegar bottle in his house is made of jade. Pure jade!
But Master Liu, how could I ever face my daughter again if I saw her to be wife of a eunuch?
I'm sorry to break it to you, but you're selling her, aren't you? Generally, children don't feel very well to be sold off by their parents, regardless of buyer. Think about it. Once they tie the knot, she will eat the finest delicacies and wear the best brocades. That sounds pretty good to me. I need you to make a decision. Get on with it?
She's my daughter. 10 taels, is that all you'll pay?
Where in your whole village can you scrape up 10 taels of silver? You know very well that in the countryside, a child can be bought with 5 catches of flour.
I'll have to talk you over with my daughter.
You just didn't get it, do you? You need to take this offer and carry on.
I'll be back as soon as I can.
Bloody hell! These country bumpkins are like a pain in the ass. It takes them forever to make a decision. It's like their brains are permanently constipated.
What's going on in the countryside? Why are they selling their children?
No idea. But the way things are going, they're even a dog want to be in Beijing.
Master Liu, you have nerve to have a hand in such a business.
I'm just a middleman here. Some people want to buy, some people want to sell. I bring them together. Hey, so, have a look at this.
Ah, it's beautiful.
Listen to it. Listen to the engine. That's precision.
How much does it cost?
Why? You like it. Then it's yours. Just 5 taels of silver. And we'll get tired of it. Return to me. I will refund the last copper of it. It's top quality. Fit for family heirloom.
You know, it really puzzles me. The amount of foreign things we all have. Take you, for example. Foreign snuff, foreign watch, a gown made of foreign satin, a jacket and trousers made of foreign cloth. Makes no sense.
Come on, foreign things are so fine. Nowadays, if I went around in country cloth, I won't get anywhere.
I still think our own satin and Sichuan silk are far more handsome.
If you say so, hey, so, you ought to buy this watch. Nowadays, if you carry a foreign watch around, people will treat you with, what's the word? Gravitas. Listen, just keep it for now. You can pay me later.
Now, old uncle, you better try somewhere else. They're trying to settle a dispute in there. No one's going to buy your things.
Yes, sir. What's that all about? What is falling for a fight?
It's over a pigeon, they say.
That flew from the Jiang families to the Li's. The Li's refused to return it, and well, let's not enter the details.
Oh! Old uncle! You must be getting on.
82. And there's no one to look after me. These days, a pigeon's better off than a man. And they can't even control where they sit.
How can you spare the time to visit the tea house with not even a servant to accompany you?
Just taking a look around to see if a young lady like you can run a business like this.
Oh, I learn as I go along. I have to. A lot of customers were friends of my father, so they're willing to look past having a female proprietor. In a business like this, you just have to be popular. Always drop compliments, try to please everybody, and that way you're in no serious trouble. Please, take a seat. I'll make you a cup of the very best tea.
I don't want any tea, and I won't sit down.
Oh, just for a minute. You'll be doing me a great honour.
All right, but don't make such a fuss.
Of course. Lisa, a pot of our very best tea, please. How's everything? How's your family? Well, and business, right?
Not so good.
You can't have much to worry about. You're one of the richest men in Beijing.
What auspicious features! Truly an inspiring forehead and a commanding jaw. Not the makeup of Prime Minister, but the potential of fabulous wealth.
You get her, go.
You have to get her. Well, very well.
Now, young lady. It has come to my attention that the amount of money I get from this place is scarcely enough to keep me in tea. Your father's payments to me were, how should I put it, less than generous.
Of course. But there's no need for you to worry about such little matters like that. Send a steward round. I'll pay a fair price with him, I will.
You rogue! You're even more crafty than your father. I'm starting to wish you didn't die so young. You just wait. One of these days, I'll take back this place.
Oh, but sir, I know just as much as you are, as you do, that you're concerned about my welfare. You wouldn't have me out on the street selling tea out of earthenware pots, would you?
Just you wait.
I'm hungry.
Get up, you can't sleep.
No, please. Find some kind person to do a good deed. Take this child. Just 2 tails of silver.
Lisa, first 2 bowls of noodles. Take them outside, please.
Yes, ma'am.
Get up. Wait at the entrance. I'll get you the noodles.
Oh my God!
Come on! Chang, you really are too kind on them buying the noodles. I tell you, there are way too many cases like that in Beijing, and you can't help them all.
Seems to me the Great Tea Empire's done for.
Whether it's done for or not has nothing to do with giving bowls of noodles to the poor. Really, Wang, I'm serious about taking back this house.
But you can't.
Oh, yes, I can. Not only the houses, but also the shops in the city and the land in the countryside. I'm going to sell them all.
But why?
I'm going to put all my capital together and start a factory.
A factory?
Exactly, a big, no, a huge factory. Let me tell you, Professor Wang, that is the only way to help the poor, keep our foreign goods, and save the empire. But what's the use of talking to you about such things? It's all above your head.
You mean to tell me you're willing to give up all your property for the sake of China? It sounds very noble, but I'm not buying it.
You wouldn't understand. It's the only way to help the poor, keep our foreign goods, and save... All right, I've stayed here long enough. Now I've seen with my own eyes that you're doing good business. Don't you dare play your tricks and refuse to raise the rent.
Let me get your
attention. Don't bother, I'd rather walk. Why, Master Ching? Your Excellency, Master Pang. You must be feeling a lot more relaxed these days. Of course, peace reigns once more. The Imperial Edict has been proclaimed, and Han Sitong is sentenced to death. I'm telling you, Master Qing, anyone who dares to meddle with the statues laid down by our noble ancestors will be struck down by the swift hand of justice. I know, Master Eunuch. Though he did have balls this time, Sitong. You can't say that about everybody these days, can you, Master Eunuch? He did have balls.
You're very clever, Master Chin. That's how you made such a mint.
My little bit of property isn't worth mentioning.
Oh, how modest you are, Master Chin. Master Chin, Master Chin. Who in Beijing hasn't heard of you, Master Chin? People say you're even more powerful than the Mandarins. You know what else people say? People say those reformists have huge support from the rich. The rich, the little upstarts with deep pockets. How deep are your pockets, Master Qing?
Well, let's not get carried away, Your Excellency. What little influence I may wield won't go far in your presence. Well said, Your Excellency. Let us both try our best and see what happens. Allow me the pleasure of paying you a visit one of these days. Goodbye.
Your Excellency, please, take a seat.
If a little upstart dares to bandy words with me, times must have really changed.
Great Eunuch Pang! May heaven bestow fortune on you. I cannot start to express what an honor it is to do business with you.
Tang Sitong.
Oh, I've heard of him somewhere before. Oh, well, probably his mother or something, if he's been sentenced to death.
Yeah, it's not a murderer, it's worse, a liberal.
Over the past 2 or 3 months, some officials and scholars have been stirring up the old shithead. Who knows what they're up to?
Well, I don't give a damn now that my benefit subsidy is safe again. I heard that Tan and Kang Youwei were talking about abolishing the subsidies altogether.
Subsidies are shit anyway. By the time we get them, the guys in the top have creamed off the best part of it. It's a dog's life, whichever way you look at it.
Sure it is, but it's better than nothing. Dog's life is better than no life at all. If I were to own my own living, I'd be 6 feet under in a week.
My friends, let's leave off discussing affairs of state, shall we?
Are you telling me that going rent for a country girl is 200 taels of silver?
Well, a country girl she might be, but what a catch. Once you have her in the city, with a little bit of makeup and a little bit of instruction, you will have a well-mannered beauty at your hand. Great Eunuch Pang, I have done more than I could for my own father. I would left no stone unturned to serve Your Excellency.
Why are you fighting?
The street is crowding with soldiers and horsemen. What is happening?
Ah, they are just cleansing the street of the reformists. No worry, Oracle. No one's gonna lay hands on you.
Oh, thank you, Your Excellency. Now, if you oblige me with a few grains of your prepared opium, I'll be most grateful.
Let's start moving too. It's getting late.
Let's go.
Just one moment.
What's the matter?
Is it just me? Or did you say just now the great Qing Empire's done for? She did, didn't she?
Me? I love the Qing Empire. I hope it's done for.
You heard her. Did she put it like that?
Did she?
No, my friend. We have tea here every day. The manager knows as well. But we are both law-abiding people.
No. I'm asking you whether or not you heard her. We can easily
We'll take you in too. Since she said the great Qing Empire is done for, I can only imagine she must be a follower of Tan Se Tong.
Well, I heard her, but she's
but get going.
What do I demand an explanation?
So you're resisting arrest? Look, I have the law here with me.
Remember, my brothers are bannermen. You chain her! Don't bother. I won't try to escape.
Just you try. You come too. Tell the truth in court, and you won't get into trouble.
Better get out of the canteen.
Let's go.
You're not going to sell me, are you? Oh, don't sell me.
Come on.
My daughter. Oh, Shunzi. I know you're Vip's papa. But you have to be brave and find somewhere to feed yourself or starve. Look, Papa just needs a few more taels of silver or I'm in big trouble. Understand? Shunzi, big girl now. You have to be brave.
Hey, you are back. And she is great. Wonderful. Come and meet His Excellency. New dumplings, Excellency.
Shunzi!
What's wrong with her?
She's so very upset, she's fainted!
I ordered something alive! I won't take it dead!
Chefe, you're
She's all for change.
But all her effort is in vain. There's certain things you can't attain.
Bloody warlords fight and curse. You're rid of one and the next one's worse. Zhao fights Tian and Sun fights Li. It makes no sense that I can see.
But in order to fight, they've got to have guns. So they waste our wealth on foreign ones. And wily old foreigners' business thrive on warlord greed and civil strife. Then come the soldiers, and the common folk lose both grain and livestock at one fell stroke.
Proprietor Wang's a reforming fool. Her place is the Arab boarding school. College kids now live in the back and fill this place with cultured talk. Still, a bunch of those soldiers out for blood could finish her tea house off for good. Hey, this isn't the time for gloomy talk, but rather to wish you the best of luck. We're opening tomorrow and everything's new. The tables, the posters, even the brew.
Besides, get back to work. We're opening tomorrow.
You're opening for business, they're opening fire. There'll be trouble tomorrow, or I'm a liar.
Get your ass over here.
Well,
She's getting on, and so is the workload.
She's been grousing all morning, but she has her grounds. I didn't want to say it in front of her, but I tell you frankly, we must get more help.
More help means more wages.
Where's the money to come from, hmm?
If I had a chance to get out of this business and didn't, I'd be a bloody fool. Oh, those bloody cannons are at it again! Your bloody rackets!
I didn't expect to hear such nonsense from you. What have the bloody cannons got to do with me?
We've been through these cannonades millions of times now, and we've never been hit. That tells me that Beijing's a blessed city.
Blessed? Blessed indeed. My heart is always in my mouth. Got to go and get some money for these damn stupid shopping.
See what I have to deal with?
Come, lady. Do us a good deed. Take pity on us.
You as well. Get out.
Have mercy. We are all refugees.
You're wasting your time. I don't even have enough for myself. Get out.
Go away. Piss off. Quick about it.
Thank God. I don't get a minute's rest. Please, sit down with me. How's everything going? Fighting fierce?
Very fierce. These refugees are everywhere. We've been insulted by our superiors that you ought to provide us with 80 catties of unleavened pancakes before noon. We must feed the soldiers in the city before we send them to the battlefield.
Right, okay, I get it, but you know that I only cater for the boarding school students now. I don't even have enough food for one catty of pancakes, let alone 80!
You have your excuses. I have my orders. Well, do as you like.
Wait, wait. We're not open yet. You know that. And when business gets going, we'll need your help more than ever. Take this. Buy yourself a small pot of tea and put in a good word for me. I'll be very grateful.
All right, I'll try. But don't count on it. Look here, sirs. I'm making Ruocheng chapter residence. This place isn't open. Them some money, and then they'll go elsewhere.
Sirs, we're not open yet, otherwise we'd be grateful for your custom.
I'm sure you understand. She really can't serve you today.
Bollocks! Bollocks! Paper money! Give us silver dollars!
Silver dollars?
But sirs, where can I get silver dollars from?
Bollocks! Beat the shit out of her!
See? Saved you from real trouble. If I stayed, it would be the end of you. Not a single teacup left.
I suppose I should be grateful.
Aren't you going to do something about it then?
Right. Well, go on then, thank me! I said I have nothing left!
I am not going to argue with you. See you tomorrow. Who knows what wind will blow tomorrow?
Well, mind your step! Damn it! We're not even open yet. War, war, all the bloody time! It has no respect for opening hours. Tired. When will it stop?
Ah, I hear someone in need of an oracle. duty.
You're doing well for yourself. In silk, too.
Well, somewhat better off than before, thanks to the tie.
Thanks to the tights.
The more chaos, the better my business. Life and death has become a matter of luck. More and more people want their fortunes told, their features read. You understand?
That's one way of looking at it.
I hear you converted the courtyard into a boarding house. What about renting me a room?
Tang, with that addiction of yours, don't you think it's best?
I've given up opium.
Really?
Yeah. I've taken up heroin. See that? Hatterman brand of cigarette? They are long and the tobacco is loosely packed. See? By gently knocking one end, you get an empty space. Just right for heroin.
No.
Well, British Imperial cigarette and Japanese heroin. Two great powers looking after poor old me. Aren't I lucky?
Yes, very lucky indeed. Unfortunately, there are no rooms left in the boarding house, but I'll let you know as soon as one becomes available.
I know you don't think much of me. You're afraid I won't pay the rent.
Nothing the sort. We both grew up in the streets. It's not my place to look down on you. See? Talking to you like an old friend.
Hey, you got a smooth tongue. Better than mine.
I'm not just saying it, I mean it. How many free cups of tea have I given you over the years? Count for yourself. And add that one as well. And now? Now that you're doing better for yourself, have you even considered to pay me back?
I'll pay you back one of these days. But all together, it'll come too much.
Paper! Paper! Hey, proprietor! Latest news about the battle in Changxingdian. Would you buy a copy?
Does it have any news about people not fighting?
Maybe. Look for yourself.
Oracle!
Oh, you just did.
I'm not like her. I'm always deeply concerned about the affair of state. Go away.
Hey, wait!
Changxingdian, that's it.
Lisa, you better go get the food now. City gates are sure to close. Lisa! Lisa!
Prior to what?
Lisa.
Chai, good to see you. What are you doing nowadays?
Selling vegetables. Earning my own living. I'm not about to buckle. Today, there was such pandemonium outside the city. I couldn't pick up any vegetables. All I got were these. Two chickens and some pickled turnips. Well, I heard you're opening tomorrow, and I thought they might come in handy, so I brought them along.
Thank you so much. I don't know how we would have managed without them.
Nice. Very nice. You've done the place up well. All the large tea houses have closed down. You were the only one to make the most of the changes and reforms.
Well, I try my best, but with the country in this state, there really wasn't a point.
Well, the likes of we will be able to afford a seat at such a posh tea house, that's for sure.
Oh, Papa Wang, you're opening tomorrow.
I'll see what I can do for
that. As you like, whatever you think I'm worth.
Let me at least get you both a pot of tea.
Chang, how's life treated you?
Oh, well, now I'm selling vegetables. Ever since the Bannerman subsidy was abolished, I earn my own living. How are you?
Me? Just hearing you ask that brings tears to my eyes. Look at my clothes. They're a disgrace.
But you read and write and do accounts. You can't find a job.
Exactly. There's nothing going. Looking back, the Great Qing Empire wasn't so good. But now in the Republic, I'm starving.
I hope that's enough. Is that an Oreo? Does it still sing?
Of course it's an Oreo. I may starve, but I won't allow my bird to. Look, he's such a handsome bird. Whenever I look at him, I don't want to die.
So you mustn't talk of dying. One day your luck will change.
Come, sister, let's go and have a drink. Drown our sorrows in wine. I'm surprised, I'd love to invite you, but I can't. Not enough money, you see.
Don't worry, I have enough work to do here.
It's you, sir, madam.
What is the matter with you? We're a republic now, you don't bend the knee. Don't you know how to bow in the new style?
Seeing your grey gowns makes me feel it's still the dynasty. I can't help but bend my knee.
Me too. I feel that bending the knee is more satisfying than bowing.
So, your Bannerman subsidy used to prove a solid source of income. But that's all gone now. I guess our grey gowns were the best bets, eh? Wouldn't you say? It's Chang, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes, you have a good memory. 20 years ago, like in 1898, I remarked that the Great Qing Empire is done for. You two arrested me and had me imprisoned for more than a year.
Your memory's not too bad either. Doing well these days.
Yes, like you. It was 1900 soon after I got up. The year of the boxes. Support the Qing and annihilate the foreigners. Oh, it seems the Great Qing Empire really was done for after all. But let me tell you, it deserved it. I may come from a family of bannermen, but I wasn't there. And now, I'm up every day before dawn. I take 2 baskets of vegetables to the city, and by 10, they're sold. I earn my own living and live an honest life. And if the foreigners ever come here again with their armies, we'll be ready to fight them. We may be bannermen, but bannermen are Chinese too. How's life treating you?
Oh, muddling along. When I was an emperor, we served him. When I was president Yuan Shikai, we served him. Now, Enzi, how should I put it?
Now we serve whoever puts rice in our bowls.
Even foreigners.
Chang, let's get going. Now, understand this, Chang. Everyone nowadays is backed by some foreign power. Foreign powers have the arms, foreign powers have the guns. How can anyone make war without arms and guns? You're so right, Teletho.
Goodbye. I'm sure you'll soon be rewarded for all your hard work.
Such a bloody fool.
Chang's very stubborn. She won't bow down to anyone. Have a cup. It's fresh.
What sort of people lodge here?
Mostly university students and a few old acquaintances. I have all of their names promptly written up on a register and they're checked with the police. Would you like me to get it for you?
We don't look at books. We look at people.
There's no need for that. I can vouch for them all, I assure you.
You're very partial to students, aren't you? They're not generally quiet types, are they?
The way I see it is,
People in office one day and out the other. Tradesmen in business one day, broke tomorrow. I can't rely on anyone. Only university students can afford the rent because only university students have the money to get in the first place. That's how I figure it.
Yes. Excellent. To the last detail. Nowadays, even we don't get paid.
That's why we must make a rest every day to get our bonus.
You see, we select people at random, but they never get out at random. Now, let's take a look back there.
There's really no need to trouble yourselves. They're all good people.
Oh, no. If we don't take a look, we can't take anyone. How will we get our bonus?
Since our friend here is not willing to let us have a look, she must have thought of another way. These are difficult times to be a lady and a proprietor. Ought to help her try keep up a front. A reputation. Sometimes a reputation's all you have as a lady. Isn't that right, proprietor? I have an idea. Not the best, perhaps. On the first of every month, you'll hand in a little
expression of gratitude.
That's it. A little token of friendship. That'll save no end of trouble for the both of us.
And how much is this token of friendship worth?
Well, as old friends, we'll leave that up to you. You seem like a bright lady. I'm sure you wouldn't want this token of friendship to seem unfriendly, would you? Would you? Would you? Are the city gates closing again today?
Yisang, you better stay at home. The soldiers on the streets, they're seizing people on conscription.
So what? If I'm here, I'll also work today.
Oh, don't go out! They're nearly grabbing me!
Yisang, leave it for now.
Oh, we have lunch!
Just tell everyone we'll have pickled garlics and rice or something.
As you wish.
Oh my lord! Almost scared me to death!
So what? You'll even buy and sell a few more girls anyway.
Don't blame me! Some people want to buy, some people want to sell. I bring them together!
Now, allow me to offer you a word of caution. Since the time of the Empire, we've been dealing with revolutionaries. We don't like dirtying our hands on slave traders and pimps like you. It's messy. But times are changing! If we catch you at it again, we won't be turning quite such a blind eye. And if the likes of you get pulled in, you'll sure as hell spend the rest of your days chained to the piss pot.
My friend, there's really no need to put it like that. I've just been down and out like everyone else. In the old days, I had my connections with those Manchu nobles and eunuchs of the court. But those old days are long gone. Since the revolution, I've been leading a dog's life. When those ministers, vice ministers, generals, and colonels, when they're taking concubines, they only want sing-song girls and Beijing opera stars. They pay thousands of few silver dollars for that. Thousands! But I cannot even get my toe into their doors. There is really no need to pick up my miserable bit of business.
You'll change your tune when you change that piss pot.
My friend, I have nothing to offer you today, but one of these days, I promise you something worthwhile.
You must be doing a deal of some sort, or you wouldn't be poking your nose around on a day like this.
No, honestly, I'm not.
There's never a word of truth to you, is there? Lying won't do you any good. Proprietor, we're going to take a walk. The first of every month, according to the new solar calendar. Don't forget.
I may forget my own name, but never your gratitude.
Well, that's settled then.
Oh,
talking. Now get out!
Don't mind me, just carry on. I have to stay here to wait for a couple of my friends.
Let me make one thing very clear to you. You need to start conducting your line of business elsewhere. We've reformed, we're civilized now!
Is this the place?
This is the place, all right. But it looks so different.
You sure, Ma?
No mistake. He's here, I'm quite sure.
Who are you looking for?
Pockmark Liu. Do you recognize me? You.
Hang on, what have I done?
What have you done? Take a good look at me. Don't you recognize me? Couldn't you have made a decent living some other way? Pah!
What talk is about it?
Are you the proprietor? Do you remember some 20 years ago now, there was a eunuch who bought a wife?
So your eunuch...
It was all his doing. And now I'm going to make him pay for it!
Well, I'm not fighting a woman. We'll get someone to make his decisions.
Calm down. Take your time. Take a seat. Where's the eunuch?
Dead. Starved to death by his nephews. After the revolution, he still had money, but no more influence. His nephews treated him badly. And after he died, they threw us out into the cold.
And this is your...
My son.
Your son?
Also bought as the eunuch's son.
Mom, is this really where your father sold you?
Yes. This is the place. I fainted as soon as I came in. I'll never forget it.
I can't remember when my father sold me.
Well, you were very young then. It's probably best that you don't remember. Now, when I saw Pockmark Liu, I wanted to slap him. But I could barely raise my hand. Oh, what a waste of time! Proprietor, since I was sold here, it seems a bit of luck that we've met again. Can you find me a job of some kind? It's not for me, but he's a good boy with no one but me to look after him. He mustn't starve.
Oh, what can you do?
Washing, cooking, sewing, mending, things like that. I'm from the countryside, I don't mind hard work. As long as I'm not a eunuch's wife, anything will be sweet.
And what do you want?
Three meals a day, a bed to sleep in, and enough to send Dali to school.
I'll ask around for you. The truth is, I never forgot what happened all those years ago. It leaves a bitter taste in my mouth.
But where can we go now?
Why don't you go to the countryside? Look for your father.
Him? I couldn't care less if he's alive or dead. He never stood by me. His own daughter. I won't call him father now.
But a job straight away is hard to come by.
He's good at housework and not asking too much. I'll keep her.
You.
This tea house is mine as much as yours. Our father left it to the both of us.
Proprietor, if you should feel for one moment that I'm not up to the job, then just say the word and I'll go.
Come with me, sister.
Come down here.
Two more mouths of thee. The eunuch's already dead and I'm landed with his family.
I told you I have to stay here to wait for a couple of my friends.
Lord, I told you to get out.
There is nothing you can do about it. Once in the trade, always in the trade. You will always be selling your teeth, and I will always be in my business. Till my dying day. Oh, Elder Brother Chen, Elder Brother Ning. Proprietor Wang, let me use your place. Just this once, I promise. It's the last time.
She's right there.
Don't worry, she can't do much. If she tries, this fella help me. Sit down, let's talk it over.
You say, second brother.
No. You say it, elder brother.
Does it really matter who says it first?
You say it. You're the elder brother.
It's like this. We are sworn brothers.
Right. Sworn brothers. So close we can share the same pair of trousers.
He's got a few silver dollars.
Silver dollars? Elder brother here also has some.
How many silver dollars do you have altogether? Tell me!
We're not going to tell you that yet.
Not till we know if it's possible.
With silver dollars, everything is possible.
Really?
If I'm lying, I'll be damned.
You say it, second brother.
No. You say it, elder brother.
You see, there are 12 of us, right?
Right. Our friendship's so close, we share the same pair of trousers, right?
Right.
No one would laugh at our friendship, would they?
Friendship is a friendship. Who laughs at that?
And no one would make fun of a friendship between three people, either?
Three people? What do you mean?
Us and a woman!
I see. But it's going to be very tricky, huh? People talk about nice young couples, right? Have you ever heard about nice young... triple?
Tricky, eh?
Very tricky.
What do you say?
Oh, we're not going to call it off. Are we?
Hell no! We've been in the army for more than 10 years and can't even end up with half a wife?
No. We won't call it off. Let's talk it over. How many silver dollars do you have altogether?
That's a tip.
Mr. Tsui, why didn't you go when Master Chin called you yesterday? You're a learned man. You know all about the heavens and the earth. And yet you spend all your time shut up here reading Buddhist scripture. A man like you should be in office. With someone like you in Parliament, ordinary people like us wouldn't have to starve.
Yes, I was in Parliament. A grievous sin. But what has the revolution accomplished? We misled ourselves and others. Now I spend my days in repentance and meditation. That's all I can do.
But look at Master Chin. With his own factory and enough to open a bank soon.
With all his factories and banks, what can he do? He says he's going to save the country through industry and commerce. But who has he saved? Himself. He's richer than ever. Yet, should the foreigners lift just one little finger, all his industry and commerce could collapse in an instant and he'll never be on his feet again.
Don't say that. Surely there's hope for us.
It's hard. Very hard to say. Today, Marshal Wang wages a war on Marshal Zhao. Tomorrow, Marshal Li attacks Marshal Wang. Who do you think is behind it all?
Who?
The foreigners.
The foreigners.
One day you'll understand when China is reduced to a colony and all of us are slaves. I took part in the revolution. I know what I'm talking about.
Then why don't you take part in it again? Stop us from being slaves.
As a young man, I thought my ideals could save the world. I tried to follow them. Now, I've seen through it all. China's finished.
But we must try to save her. People like us.
Save her? That's just wishful thinking. The corpse can't be brought back to life. Everything dies sooner or later. I'm off to the Hongji Temple. If Master Chin should send for me again,
Tell him I'm only interested in chanting Buddhist scriptures.
Elder brother, shall we go?
Oh, yeah.
Not quite yet. What's up?
Why don't you tell me what's up?
I heard you'll come quietly.
Where to?
Deserters, right? Hiding in Beijing with a few silver dollars in your pockets, right? And when that runs out, you go and become bandits, right?
That's none of your bloody business. I can lick eight of your sort with one hand.
Right.
You sure? It's the same you sold your gun. I can lick eight of your sort with one finger.
Look here, we're all friends. No need for unpleasantness.
Oh, I like this one. Let's sit down and have a little chat, shall we? Make a decision. Your silver dollars or your lives?
We went through hell having this bit of money. We fought for whoever would pay us. Shit! The number of battles we fought.
I don't like this one.
You don't get it, do you?
Are you aware of how they treat deserters?
No. Let's talk it over. After all, we're all friends.
Yes, that's the way to talk among friends. Now, let's get down to business.
The execution squad's coming.
Stop! Our word of honor. You split the silver dollar with us, and we'll keep you safe. After all, we are friends, right?
Yeah, friends!
May I report, sir? We're interrogating a deserter here.
Him?
Who?
Yes.
Me him.
Tie him up.
No.
Tie him up.
I'm an innocent. You have listened to me. You cannot do this to me. No, you are a soldier. No.
Shall we?
Yes. Let's go make a living.
Tree's limbs are bent and spare,
An old girl's back is bent with care. I'm finding it hard to get along, just like her friend replied to Wang. She's getting poor and on in years, and the threadbare jacket's all she wears. 8 years the Japanese occupied old Beijing, old China's pride. The people suffered without relief, every day filled with death and grief. Until the Eight Fruit Army won their hearts as it drove the cruel invaders out. They gazed with hope at the stars and the moon. Victory promised a new life soon. Ah, now the Kuomintang are in Beijing, outdoing the Japs at everything. Troubles without end plague Proprietor Wang. Neither she nor Rao be around too long. The old tea house is a pretty sad case. Nothing seems to work these days. The country, too, is in a terrible mess, while those at the top roll in foreign cash.
Xiaohua!
I know, my dear, but who knows if there'll be any flour in the shops today. Even if there is some, we don't know if we can afford it.
Even if you are lucky, any flour around the moment is going to the highest bidder.
I hope there's plenty left for us. You can hope, but that won't get you far. Off you go now. The cut off seems deep on your way.
So what? Wait.
What is it, Dad?
About last night.
I've warned her. She's a sensible child.
Look. Don't tell anyone about your Uncle Daddy. If you do, we're all in big trouble. Understand?
I won't say a word, even if they kill me. If anyone asks me about Uncle Daddy, I'll just say he's been gone for many years, no news about him at all.
Good girl.
Xiaohua! Oh, you're still here? Grandma, what is it?
Let me get another look at you. So pretty, but too thin. The more to eat, you'd look even better.
She's already eating half the food in the pantry. Don't think I didn't see you sneaking off yesterday.
I'm sorry.
Don't worry, my girl. You're still growing.
Aunt, have you made up your mind to go?
Yes, I'll go. I don't want to be a burden to you. I brought Dali up, and now he wants me to go with him. How can I refuse? When we first came here, he wasn't even as big as Xiaohua is now.
But Uncle Daddy is so big and brave and strong now.
Yes, isn't he? He was hardly here for long, but it made me feel so much younger. I haven't a thing in the world, but when I see him, I feel I've everything. But yes, I'll go. With him, hardship or sufferings will be sweet. You saw his big hands and feet. He's become a real man.
Granny, I want to go with you.
You'd be a good girl now and go to school. I'll come back and see you.
Xiaohua, go to school now. Don't be late.
I'll take her. I've heard there's some disturbance out there today.
Thank you. You guys better get going.
Granny, don't go. Don't go. Come back.
Yes, yes. Run along now, my dear.
Aunt. Has Mom agreed to let you go yet?
She hasn't decided yet. What worries me is, if Dali's visit somehow leaks out and then I suddenly disappear, it may mean trouble for you. People are getting arrested all the time. I don't want to let you down.
Now, Aunt, you just go ahead. You'll have a chance to live if you go away.
That's right.
Well, Xiaohua, let's talk it over. I mustn't think of myself only and let the rest of you suffer for it. Dashwan, you better think it over too.
Oh.
are you?
I'm Little Ding Dong. Pockmark Liu Jr. told me to come in. He says the old manager here is asking for come on hostess.
Take a good look around, miss. You think a damn place like this need a common hostess? But the old manager here is so desperate for money, she's always thinking of some crazy scheme.
She?
Now, Dash One, who taught you to talk down your elders? Who is full of crazy schemes? Open the curtains, the tea house should have opened long ago. Are you the manager?
Yes.
Believe it or not, some women do have other roles than waitressing and childbearing.
Yes, Mom. Sorry, you haven't eaten good today?
Not done too badly, have I? This is the only large tea house in Beijing still going, and it's run by a woman. What does that tell you?
Yes, Mom.
If there was a large bowl of noodles with fried bean sauce around, I'd pack away three large bowls. Maybe there aren't any. None at all. Still in your teens, miss?
I'm 17.
Only 17.
Yes. My mother was a widow, tried to bring me up. After the war, the government insisted that the little house my father left us was transported and took it away from us. The shock killed my mother, so I became a common hostess. Old manager, I still don't know what traitor's property means. Do you know?
You better watch your tongue, girl. One word of traitor's property and anything can go down. Take the place back there. It used to be a factory of Master Qin. And then someone said it was traitor's property and vanished.
Oh, you said it, old manager. Even I'm traitor's property. I've just suck up to whoever the boss was. Hell, I'm only 17 and I often wish I was dead. At least my body would be my own. This job rots you away slowly.
Mom, do we really need a common hostess? Come on!
I've spoken to Pockmark Liu Jr. about it. Well, with business this bad, I'm worried.
I'm worried too, but think about Gu Yutai's old name. 6 years of standing, not hiring common hostess.
Respectable old name? The owner something is more worthless it becomes. You don't believe me? If I were 28 years old, I'd call myself Tiny Dingbell or Ding Baby. But I bet no one would ever look at me twice.
Oh, my friend, your own. And you brought your own tea. Dutch one, go and get some hot water. Now, I'm very sorry, but I must ask that you pay up front.
That's bullshit.
I know, and in my 50 years of business, I've not heard of anything like it either. But as you know, prices of coal and oil and such things are going up and up. They might even go up while you're having your tea now. So, it just saves us all a lot of trouble if you pay now.
Well, having no tea at all saves me even more trouble.
It's very good tea. They don't even try and get a shake bags now or something.
What? She's gone.
You see what I mean?
That doesn't mean we need her.
Dash one! You're as stubborn as a mule.
Huh. Do what you like. Find it stuffy. I need a walk.
You find it stuffy? I can hardly breathe.
Leon, Little Ding Dong, you've made it!
On your orders, how could I refuse?
Old manager, how do you like this little young baby I've found for you? The look, the age, the fashion, the experience.
It'd be wonderful if I could afford her.
No problem. This girl comes wage free.
No wages.
Me and baby have got away all worked out, haven't we, baby?
Sure.
Without your crooked ways, where would you be?
Crooked? You've said that. So was my old man. He was taken away right here. One day, he came to the tea house. And the next thing he knows, the execution squad is chopping off his head as a deserter. The crazy thing is, he was never even a soldier. I'm telling you, if you don't believe me, ask the manager.
Isn't that so?
Saw it with my own eyes.
See, baby? I'm not just shooting my mouth off something that doesn't exist. He was dragged right into the middle of the street, and with one big whack of sword. His head was chopped off. Right, old manager?
Landed right on my doorstep.
My father didn't have what he takes. All that work, he still didn't get far. But now, it's my turn, and I'm going to hit the big time. Okay, you have to look at my plan. And old manager?
I think I'll come back tomorrow.
Ding-bao, I haven't made my mind up yet.
Old manager, I've made it for you as well. You see, tomorrow morning, baby will stand at the entrance and give everybody the eye, and immediately you will have 200 customers at your hand. 200! Hey, baby, you need to listen carefully because you are in it.
Ugh, I was hoping I wasn't.
Hey, what's the matter, baby? You're so negative. You have to listen to me. This is very important.
Hey, manager, your electricity bill. How many months has it been?
3.
I'll give it 3 more months and it'll be half a year. And I still wouldn't be able to pay.
Bullshit.
No. She is serious. This joint is under Director Shen's control. Do you have an idea who he is? Member of the KMT Party Committee. Chief Director of the Military Police. You don't want to collect his electricity bill. Come on, tell us!
What do you mean? No, sorry. I guess I came to the wrong place.
See, old manager, you cannot do anything without me. Your Qing Dynasty method is way out of date.
Well, as they say, one must live and learn.
Now you are talking. I've told you before. Hey, Yatang Ultra Junior, it's you!
Oh, shit, it's you! Pockmark Junior, you little bastard! Come on, let me give you a gander. In that Western gear from behind, you look more foreign than a foreigner! Old manager. I've been studying the stars, and there is irrefutable evidence that the true Son of Heaven will come among us very soon now. That's why prodigies like me and Pockmark Jr. and
Little Ding Bao.
Little Bao. Whoa, look at us, endowed with wit and beauty, accomplishing letters and poems, just right for the time. Ah, boy, are we gonna enjoy it? Oh, manager, turn your face here. I'll read your feature. Good. Good. A fine forehead. You're in for a spell for good luck. How about a cup of tea?
Oracle Junior.
Don't call me Oracle anymore. My new title is Tang the Court Astrologer.
Who gave you that?
You'll hear about that in a few days.
Well, Tang the Court Astrologer, your mother had 3 tea of me her entire life. That's not hereditary, I know.
When I put my special robes on, you will regret what you've just said. You just wait.
Come, my old friend. Later, I will treat you to a coffee with little baby here to keep us company. But before that, I want to tell you something very important. Just now, I was saying to baby, I have a tremendous plan.
I'm all ears.
I want to set up a trust. It's an American word, probably you don't understand. In Beijing dialect, it's boneyard. It means a place that looks after everything.
Of course I know what you mean. You want to take over all the pretty girls in Beijing.
Exactly. Baby, you need to listen carefully because you are part of me and even the old lady here is involved.
I'm listening.
I want to set up a huge trust and bring together all the taxi dancers, whores, license, and eye license, taxi jeep girls, welcome hostesses, and set up a huge trust.
Got all the official backing you need?
Sure. Dr. Shen will be the chairman of the board, and I will be the general manager.
And me? I'm not going to be one of your bitches.
Oh, don't worry about that. No one will pay for a girl like you anyway. Chief consultant. Nowadays, it would be really nice to have a woman at the top to tease those liberals.
I won't be paid in worthless government.
No Chinese sheet. American dollars. Mint. Every month.
Fire away.
I'm talking about four departments. Purchase and sales, transport, training, and service. We buy girls, we sell girls. We transport from Shanghai to Tianjin, from Hong Kong to Chongqing. We can come our hostesses, waitresses, girls for the Yanks, girls for us, and all of this will be handled by our firm. Satisfaction guaranteed. Permission apply.
Marvelous, marvelous. As far as the management theory goes, it's in line with all the rules. Better still, it satisfies the demand from both the Yankee soldiers and the state of war.
Now, it's up to you to think of a really nice name. Something, poetic, like, Wailly Five Rose, Elven Curl Eyes, Cherry Lips, something really elegant.
Trust. Everyone asks. Trust. 托拉斯. No, that's not classy at all. In Beijing dialect, it translates to drag, pull, tear. I don't want to be negative, but it does sound a bit like a kidnapping company. And that's not classy at all.
Sound classy, but it's an American word, and American word is fashionable.
I still think that something corroborated sounds better. It's got more taste.
You probably got a point here, but the problem is, what incorporated?
How about kidnappers incorporated?
Hey, this is serious. If you do your work really well, I can definitely make you the chief instructor of witnesses.
What about to blood them incorporated? What do pretty girls make you men think of? Blood them. If people want these girls, they will spend a lot of money. And your business will, what? Blood them. The two blood them. And in traditional opera and shit like that, they're all references to two blood oaths. People like that stuff. What do you think?
My old friend, thank you. Thanks a lot. I will go to see Director Shen immediately. And if he approves, I will definitely make you the chief instructor of witnesses. No, chief instructor of consultants.
Didn't you say something about coffee?
Oh, see if Tang's coming.
Oh, you go ahead. I'm expecting someone here.
Then let's get going, baby.
See you, old manager. See you, court astrologer.
Okay.
Oath manager, where's the paper?
I'll have a look for it. Perhaps there's a copy from 2 years ago lying around somewhere. And I wouldn't drink the tea if I were you. I've started replacing it with sand.
Oh, stop. Stop talking nonsense.
My friends, please pay up front.
We all know that, proprietor.
Paying up front. I'm embarrassed to even ask it.
How about it, proprietor? What do you think of storytelling as an added attraction in the evenings?
I already tried. To increase the electricity bill, not the customers.
Exactly. Take me for example. The day before yesterday, I was at Hui Xian Teahouse telling the story of how 3 gallons, 4 horses, 5 brakes, 9 elders, 10 heroes, 13 slappies, and 15 youngsters stormed the Phoenix Mountain. How the 100 birds paid homage to the Phoenix, and how the Phoenix leg was hurt. Do you know how many came to my show?
How many? You're the only one left that can tell that story.
2 connoisseurs, but only 5 turned up, and 2 of them didn't even pay.
Well, you're better off than me. I had another month without work.
But why did you give up storytelling into Beijing Opera?
I have the voice and the looks.
But on the stage, you don't throw yourself into the part.
Damn it! I sing the entire opera, and yet I barely have enough to buy 3 buns.
Well, Fuxi, it looks like you've been beaten up by the pop songs and trash opera dust. The way I feel about it, Fuxi, it doesn't matter if we live or die, but it breaks my heart to think what's left of our art. Well, we'll die out in a few years. So sad.
Fung, come over here. What happened to my 2 cookery sets? You promised me good money for those. I need that money.
Oh, Chef, why don't you take one of the scrolls instead?
But what would I do with a scroll?
They're so well painted, better than the original.
It may be the best painting in the world, but it still won't fill my belly.
When the owner handed them to me, he was in tears.
So was I when I handed over my knives and my wok. But you're surely not going to rob an old friend, I hope.
Only 2 sorts of cookware, wasn't it? Peanuts. If you value a friendship, don't bring them up again.
Dumb. I can't even remember what silver dollars look like.
Oh, haven't you looked at that old woman? Free of charge? You're in pure emergency!
What, astrologer?
At your service!
Dumb Dumb! Oh, yes, ma'am, just a minute.
Oh, yes.
You're in pure emergency!
Have a look. Oh, let's hear the jingle of yours. It just kills me!
Ma'am. Yankee needle, Yankee thread, toothpaste white and lipstick red, patent Porsche's facial lotion, style of shear, you'll find here, in my small box, all goods are fine, but atom bombs just ate my life. That's so fun.
Chunmei, put these away.
That she doesn't cheat you.
Yes, ma'am. Anyone else want to buy something? Yankee needle.
Oh, do shut up and go away!
Sure. Let's go, Dumb Dumb. Your Imperial Majesty! I managed to get hold of a set of cloisonné incense burners, 5 pieces in all, antiques, the real thing. The cheapest though, just good for the mental too. Why not going to have this coronation, so my congratulations. I'll go get the incense burners and take them to the altar. If my Imperial Majesty can put in a good word for me, I won't forget it.
Fang, what about our bit of business?
Oh, just keep the straws for the time being.
Hey, wait! Don't think you can just cheat me on my words! I still have my meat chopper with me!
Manager Wang, is Aunt Kang here? Can you please go fetch her?
I'll do it. Oh, Mrs. Kang, please come here.
What's all this about?
Momentous affairs of state.
His imperial robes are all ready, and the coronation is about to take place in the Western Hills.
The Western Hills?
Old lady. Old lady, don't you know the communist 8th Route Army units are in the Western Hills? When Master Pan becomes the emperor, he'll swipe out these commies. Of course, the Nanjing government is all for it.
You see, I've got nothing against a master, but recently he's taken to abusing women. In fact, he's got several concubines already.
But, Your Majesty...
What?
An emperor should have 72 concubines, apart from his...
But you're not an emperor! How can you know what an empress has to suffer? I've got an idea, old lady. Inside of me, I'll make you Empress Dowager. Between us, we'll have the Emperor under our thumbs. That would make my life so much easier. So, come with me and I'll make sure you have the best for the drink. And a few silver dollars jingling in your pockets. A posh life.
And if I refuse?
What? Refuse?
Give her time to think it over. Give her time.
I don't need it. I finished with the puns. Wife of my fourth nephew, why don't you carry on being an empress and I'll carry on being a poor old woman? Did you really think that drawing a scene would scare me? After all these years on my own, I know how to take care of myself. Just you try. I'll teach you a lesson.
Old lady,
as for you, you young loafer, why don't you stand on your own 2 feet and make a decent living?
This evening. Suppose I die before then.
Ha! Then good riddance.
Have you ever seen a better act?
I've no more than 200 operas, and I've never come across this one before. Where did that old cow come from?
Everyone knows that. Her father is a local gangster who rules the Eastern District in Beijing. And she herself, before she got married, gave birth to, let's not go into details. I'm telling you, those thugs are having their last fling before they go under. It won't be long now.
Juan, take care of things here. I've got some business to attend to.
Brother Dashuan, a pot of the very best. I'm in the money today. Work this out for me. Just spend one, got four left. If a student is a half dollar each, how many students have I done it?
10.
That's right. 4 the day before yesterday, 6 yesterday. That's 10 now, right? Brother Dashuan, here's a few silver dollars. When I'm in the money, I pay you for your tea. When I'm out of money, I drink your tea for free. Okay? That's a good one. Take them. Oh,
how is it, Junior? What are you up to? Silver dollars still grow on trees.
I am studying at the university.
You can't even read. How come you're at university then?
The Beijing KMT party sent me to the Institute of Law and Politics. What a push over. Better than mixing those bumps at Tianqiao. They give me half a silver dollar for every student I mark. How many students did I get yesterday again?
6.
That's right, including 2 chicks. One punch after another. For the last one, feel these muscles. Reinforced concrete. Imagine these guns hailing down on the students. Smashing, eh?
They're so weak, they let you beat them.
I only pick on the weak ones. Think I'm crazy?
Oh, just Junior, beating up people is no way to make them live in.
Well, I won't be beating up more students today.
Why only today? You should quit it all together.
I've got another job today.
What is that?
On teachers.
Beat up students bad enough, now you want to start on teachers.
I'm only doing what I'm told. I heard the teachers are going on strike. That means they're breaking the law. That means they'll get what's coming for them. A beating. I'm here to beat up any teachers I see.
Let's move.
Brother Dashuan, take this silver dollar.
I won't take any money you get beating up girls.
Then take this one. I got this one from beating up blokes. That's okay, isn't it? How about this? You keep an eye open for me. Run out and treat you to a good nosher. What's life without good food, good drinks, and a bit of fun?
If you've changed your mind and want me to stay, I will. But if I want dead for our tea house.
How do you know? It doesn't bode well to mess with the Tri-Emperor Society.
What really worries me is Dali's visit last night. If word of that gets out, we're all finished. You know that's worse than destroying the tea house.
Aunt, you'd better go. I'll see you off. Mom, I can see her. Can I?
Where am I? All these years, Auntie has done so much for us. The least we can do is see her off.
Did I say no? Go see her off.
Aunt, wait a minute. I'll fetch my coat.
Ma, what's the matter?
Stop asking me so many questions. I'm very muddled. I've been this muddled before. Siyang, you go with Aunt Kang. I'll tell Dashuan to follow. And if there's any trouble, you come straight back.
This will always be your home, Auntie.
Who knows what.
And I'll never forget you. Old manager, I wish you good health yourself. Good health. What's the use?
One pot of tea, proprietor.
Right.
Yuan, perhaps this will be our last time in the tea house. I may be coming a lot from now on. I've decided to give up teaching and drive a pedicab. You certainly are more than a primary school teacher. It's crazy. Being a gym teacher when both the kids and I are starving.
Well, why are you back from school so early?
There's a teacher strike, it's chaos out there.
Oh, teacher, shit, you won't have school today. Aren't you going to teach us anymore? Oh, please come back, we miss you so much. We're all crying. I won't promise to behave and never make you angry again.
We hate upsetting your studies as much as you do. But we can't teach an empty stomach. We've children of our own. It isn't fair to let them starve while we teach other children, is it? There. Don't worry. After we finish our tea, we're going to a meeting. Maybe we can find a way out. stay at home and revise your lessons. Don't go fooling around, Xiaohua.
Teachers, you'd better go. They have a thug lying in wait. Oh, this is Junior. He was here a minute ago. He can be at any time.
Gentlemen, here's your money back. Now go. Please go.
Come with me.
我的大双, where are you going? What are these two?
Customers.
Hey, stop. Oi, stop.
I don't.
Let's get out of here.
You just watch, you old fool. You let them get away this time, and they'll pay for that. Maybe I can't take on them too, but I sure can beat up an old woman like you.
I've seen many men like him in my time, and bullies like that are just cowards.
But what if he comes back here after you?
Me? Grandma knows how to talk her way out of anything.
Where's Dad gone?
Don't worry. Go and revise your lessons, Xiaohua.
I hope nothing happened to my teachers.
Shabby old place like this.
I've no time to explain. You better think of something quick.
Thank you for letting me know.
I just want to help you. There's one large tea house in Beijing and it's run by a woman. It tells me it's a bloody good tea house. Oh, please don't tell me.
I won't, don't worry.
Okay, I'll see you later.
They've gone. Good. Dashuan said not to worry. He'll see her to Dali's and come straight back. Oh, what does it matter if he goes there or stays here?
Well, what's the matter? Why are you so upset?
Nothing. Go and look after Xiaohua. Didn't she say she was hungry? If there's any flour left, go make her a bowl of noodles. Poor girl, she doesn't get enough to eat.
I'm sure these days I'm that girl's personal waitress. I serve her more than I serve the customers. I'll try and make some coarse dumpling soup. There isn't a scrap of decent flour left in this house.
Old manager, has she agreed yet?
Tonight. I promised you an answer tonight.
You're complaining that my mother never paid for her tea. So, in return, here's a piece of advice that may save your skin. Listen, the Tri Empress Society is much worse than the Japanese. They'll smash up your tea house without a back and forth. You better watch out.
Save my skin! You just want a yes to impress that bloody empress of yours.
Oh, my friend! Quite a busy day, huh?
Too damn busy. There's a teacher's rebellion.
So when did a strike become a rebellion anyway?
So what's happening?
They will get away with it. We've written 100 of them and beaten the shit out of 60 or 70 more. They'll teach them.
They don't know a good thing when it's staring them in the face. If they just keep in line, the Yankees will send over boatloads of rice and flour.
Exactly. If there is any rice and flour on the way, don't forget me. When the time comes to divine an auspicious site of your ancestral tomb, I will do it for free. Well, my friend, back to business.
Manager, you are asking how strike
can't keep up with the times.
You all belong to the same bunch.
I'm flattered.
We've got no time to waste on you, so make it snappy.
What do you want?
There's someone behind the rebellion.
Who was here last night?
Kang Dali.
That's the man. Hand him over.
If I knew he was such a character, would I really be telling you his name?
Cut the crap and give it to us straight.
Money or the man, right?
Father taught you well, didn't he? You said it yourself. Either the man or the gold bars you stashed away. You see, other shops, they come and go. But you've managed to keep your head above water, haven't you? You must have a neat little pile stashed away somewhere.
Come on, the rebellion's getting out of hand. We need to get out of here.
You little bastard, don't you know what we hired you for?
I did my fucking best. Look at what it did to my face.
Manager, we'll be back soon. So make up your mind.
Suppose I'm not here.
Giving us some of your liquor, you old wench, will fall into death of hell.
Yeah, what?
Without Kang at once.
I'll get myself up.
Remember to have some clothes, Xiaohua. Well, we can't leave you here by yourself.
This is my tea house, and I'll stay with you until I die.
Oh, Mom.
Xiaohua. This is a photo of the old tea house. It was taken 20 years ago. Give it to your father. Now go, go.
Mom will only spend a couple of days.
Ah, wonderful news, Manager Wong, wonderful news. Director Shen has approved my plan.
Congratulations.
Congratulations to you too. He has also approved the plan of fixing this place up. As soon as I mentioned it, he said, okay. It's the way he says it. Okay. Just like a foreigner.
What's all this about?
Oh, this place will be managed by me. And I want you to clear out. Got that straight? Because I don't want you pestering me later on.
Well, it just so happens I was moving out of here myself.
Oh, Ma, the old manager's been here for decades. There's no way to treat her.
Well, I always play fair. Old woman, I'm going to fetch Dr. Shen to have a look at this place. And I want you to tidy it up. Got that straight? Let's go.
Wonderful. Wonderful. Lisa! Where are the keys to the tea house? We haven't had to lock away in years.
I don't know. Why are we locking up?
Bring them to me.
Of course.
Wonderful. Truly wonderful. Just the person I wanted to see come here, my friend. Let me go get a pot of the very best tea.
Just like old times.
Is Proprietor Wang here?
Yes, there you are.
My name's Chin.
Master Chin. Fancy seeing you here.
Master Chin. The other person I wanted to see coming in from me. Please come sit down.
I've got some peanuts here. Tea and peanuts. What more could you want?
Having some teeth would help.
It's funny, isn't it? We finally managed to get a hold of some peanuts, and we've no teeth left to eat them with. What can I do for you?
I've got nobody else to talk to, so I've come to you. I've just been to Tianjin to have a look at my factory.
Your factory? Don't tell me they've given it back to you. I thought it was confiscated.
It's been demolished.
Demolished?
Demolished. 40 years of my sweat and blood raised to the ground. Others may not know it, but you too, Manager Wang. From my 20s, I advocated national salvation through industry. And now, when they seized my factory, I couldn't lift a finger. I was a nobody. I was no match for them. But it was a good factory. Well run. It could have made money for the country and benefited the people. Now it's been demolished and all the machines have been sold as scrap. Where in the world, in the whole wide world, can you find a government like this one? I ask.
Years ago, when my tea house was doing just fine, you came in and you wanted to start your factory. And I warned you.
Perhaps you'll remember too. It was around that time I gave that poor woman selling her child 2 bowls of noodles. You mocked me.
Well, I know better now. Proprietor Wang, I want to ask you a favor. My factory has been razed to the ground, and this is all that I picked up from the rubble. This pen has my name engraved on it, a witness to the number of checks I signed and the number of plans I drew up. I'll leave this with you. You can tell your customers stories about it. When business is slow, tell them, once upon a time, there was a foolish man called Chin who dreamt of opening factories. He ran one for years and years, and he ran it well. But in the end, when time's wheel turned again, there was nothing left of that factory but this little nothing that he salvaged from the rubble. Tell them, you tell them that if they have money, they should spend it all on wine, women, and gambling. Hard work's a waste of time. Never try to do anything useful. And tell them that your friend Chin was in his 70s before he discovered this. A real bloody fool.
You better take care of the pen yourself. I'm moving out of here too.
Where to?
It doesn't matter. Check.
Master Tin. I'm not as great as you. Master Tin, you had great wealth and great ambitions. But as they say, it's the tall tree that bears the brunt of the storm. And Chad, you were always kind. You never accepted injustice to yourself or to others. And you never feared the consequences. But me, my whole life, I have tried to please everybody. I bowed and I scraped to everyone. I only did it so we could have a normal life. So my children would have enough to eat and wear and not have to worry about calamity or disease. And then when the Japanese came, my second son, he ran off. My husband died of grief and worry. And then when the Japanese left, when they finally left, we thought life would be better. We hoped life would be better.
I'm no better off than you. I earned my own living and lived an honest life. But where did that get me? Selling peanuts in my 70s. One man doesn't matter. What does matter? What really matters is our country. And if only China could pull herself together and put an end to the humiliation suffered at the hands of foreigners. Well.
When the Japanese were here, they called it cooperation. Well, they cooperated my factory right out of my hands. And when our own government came back, somehow my factory became traitor's property. All the goods in the warehouse. Come.
Reform. Change. Keeping up with the times. When the tea house didn't make it, I opened up a boarding house. When that folded, I even bought in a storyteller. And then, after all of that, I even tried hiring a cowboy hostess. So what if I lost a little face? I had to live, didn't I? Who have I wronged? Who? Those bastards in the imperial family live a life of luxury and I can't even get enough food to fill my belly.
I only wish people would be reasonable and fair with one another. I saw with my own eyes my friends one by one murdered, starved to death. To go and beg to get a coffin for her. And she was lucky, lucky to have a friend like me who could get her a rough coffin of thin planks. What will happen to me when my time comes? I love my country. I see a funeral go by. I pick up some of this paper money. I won't have any burial clothes. I won't even have a coffin. All I can do is pick up some of this paper
some money.
Master Chang, why don't we scatter some of your funeral money and pay some last respects to ourselves, the three old fools?
Right. Do it like in the olden days, Chang.
How bearers of the four corners from the family, a reward of 120 strings of cash!
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 120 strings of cash! What else is there to say? Farewell.
Farewell, my friend.
One last bowl of your tea. Farewell.
Farewell, my friend. My friend.